Good morning to everyone. Today I like to discuss the oscillator, which is very important device for various applications in electronics and telecommunication and various electronic circuits. So, you see, the oscillator is an electronic device which produces the periodic electronic signal as the output of the DC power to AC power, means without any input signal, it gives the output periodic electronic signal. This is the specialty of the oscillator. Through the various electrical components used in the oscillator circuit, the oscillating signals are used in the radio, television, transmitters, computer clock to regularize, to synchronize the computer clocks and processing speed, and quartz clock. There are various type of oscillating signals, like the wave shapes are well known. That is, here it is sinusoidal wave, that is at t is equal to 0, amplitude is 0, and then there is a change of the amplitude with respect to time. Cosinusoidal wave, when t is 0, amplitude is maximum, and then there is a variation of the wave with respect to time. The square wave, at a particular time t by 2, the amplitude is constant and then it is constant and then 0. Sawtooth wave, sometimes it is also called a triangular wave. This is triangular wave, that is rise of the amplitude with respect to time, and then there is a sharp fall, and then there is a rise of the time. So this kind of the wave is sawtooth wave. The pulsating voltage also that is produced. Now if you see the block diagram of the oscillator is, so in a very simple way we can call this is amplifier, and in this amplifier this is the VI, that is input signal, here it is input signal, and then there is a output signal. In the amplifier, if there is feeding the few proportional voltage from output to input, then it's work as suppose this is a amplifier, here it is the output, and this part of this is something given in this form. This is say positive, and here it is negative VI. This is V0 initial output voltage. So due to the single stage, this is minus, here it is positive, because output is out of phase in comparison to input. So here it is positive, this gives negative, here it is negative, this gives the positive potential. And we use this network, say R1, R2, two resistance, And then part of this is feedback. This much voltage is feedback, say Vf. Voltage is feedback. And this is positive and here it is negative. So this feedback voltage Vf modified this input and this is Vi dash. Vi dash, the modified input. When modified input is there, then there is a modified output Vo dash. So Vo dash is, this is modified output. This is modified output and here Vi dash is modified input. This is modified input. Now, how much is this modified? The modification of this part is Vf, and this Vf can be calculated with the help of the given network, that is the potential drop across the resistance R2. How this one is? Say V potential, this V potential is distributed through the network. So the current in the network, current in the network is given as I is equal to voltage upon resistance. Voltage upon resistance, and this voltage is V0 and the resistance is R1 plus R2. The resistance is R1 plus R2. So this complete potential V0 is distributed over the two resistances R1 and R2. The feedback voltage that is Vf is the potential drop across the potential drop across the resistance, that is Vf is equal to I into R2. I is V0 upon R1 plus R2 into R2. R1 plus R2 upon R2. So, this R2 upon R1 plus R2 into V0. This is Vf. This quantity is beta, and say this beta is equal to R2 upon R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2, this is a dimensionless quantity. This is dimensionless quantity. So this value, that is Vf is equal to beta V0, this feedback voltage from the given circuit to the input. So, due to the presence of this Vf, this input is modified and the modified input is expressed as V1 dash. So, this V1 dash can be expressed in terms of V0 and gain of the given circuit. So, what we find, the modified input, that is Vi dash can be expressed as Vi dash is Vi minus beta V0, minus beta V0. And also we have this A, also have the gain in the circuit as this gain is VO dash, VO upon this is VI dash, VI dash. And when it is modified, then we are this Vi dash is equal to V0 dash by A, V0 dash by A due to modification, In this modification, we have the equation as Vi dash is equal to Vi minus beta V0 dash, because this modified value, modified output value is feedback to the input. Or substituting the value Vi dash, is V0 dash upon A is equal to Vi minus beta V0 dash. So, if we transfer this minus beta V0 dash from right hand side to left hand side, so we have this V0 dash upon A plus beta V0 dash is equal to Vi. So, this V0 and this V0, if V0 dash taking common, so this is 1 by A plus beta is equal to Vi. So, this equation can again be written as V 0 dash upon Vi is equal to A, this is 1 plus A beta, and this V0 are the feedback, gain is expressed as, AF is equal to V0 dash by Vi, or this is A, 1 plus A beta is AF. This is feedback gain, the feedback gain due to the part. Now, if we go through the circuit, how to design the circuit. So, for circuit, we have this is transistor, this is your transistor, here it is the plus VCC, This is base, collector, and emitter. And the part of this part is feedback to this. See, so this is VI, this part is VF, and here this is VI dash, the modified voltage, this resistance is say R1 dash, here it is R2 dash, this resistance is R1, this resistance is R2. This is RC, this is RE, this is CE. Now it is grounded. So this part of the input is feedback to the circuit. And this kind of the mechanism that we are putting this voltage in the input is termed as the series voltage feedback. So on the basis of the feedback nature, we can have this one is the mechanism. So we have the voltage and there is a current, voltage feedback, and there is a current feedback. So this circuit is series voltage feedback. There is parallel voltage feedback also. So if we want to express parallel voltage feedback, then for the parallel voltage feedback, what we have to do, this is A, here it is the voltage, so this plus minus. Here it is minus plus. So the part of this network, that is beta network, is here. So this is beta network. This is positive point, this is negative point. And for the parallel, we have to connect like this. This one is it. This one is the parallel. So it is connected to this positive terminal, is connected to positive terminal here, and negative terminal is connected to negative terminal. Similarly, in case of current feedback, this is first is parallel current, that is given something like this. This is the feedback network, and here it is given the current, and this current is something given as, this is plus minus, this is minus, that is plus, this one is, and series circuit, this is this one is here it is the current, and this current is added in this way. So this part is the parallel voltage and current. Here it is series, this series current feedback, is current feedback. This is voltage, series voltage feedback. So we are doing this kind of the circuit here. It is positive, negative, this is negative, and here it is positive, and this positive here. Positive, negative, this negative is big in this case. Now one important thing, during this feedback, what actually will happen? The input is out of phase to the output. So if we take this input out of phase of this part, so we can have the negative feedback. Negative feedback. So in this negative feedback, we take this Vf is equal to minus beta V0 dash. So minus beta V0. So modified part is this is this is minus of this, that is Vi plus beta V0. We have the same gain. Again the modified this part is Vi minus beta V0 dash, that is Vi plus beta V0 dash. So this is plus beta V0 dash, here it is minus beta, this is the minus beta V0, so this is the minus beta V0, and this is the minus beta V0, and this minus beta V0 has the important, this minus beta V0 has the important of this as case 1, when we take this case as in a separate way. Case 1, when this 1 is less than A beta, or this Vt is less than A beta Vt. So what will this A beta Vt, that is output, so this is termed as built up voltage, and this built up voltage is something like this. This is time, and this is Vt, built up voltage. Case 2, when 1 is greater than A beta, or Vt is greater than A beta Vt, so this is die out voltage means we have this kind of the voltage. We have this kind of voltage, which is Vt, A beta, Vt is this one. The third and final case 3 is when 1 is equal to A beta, or Vt is equal to A beta Vt, that is 1 minus A beta is equal to 0. If this is equal to zero, then what will happen? From this expression, AF is equal to A upon zero, that is infinity. That is infinity. So, this can be represented as, this can be represented as this. This is zero, this is Vt, A beta Vt means this is known as sustained voltage. This is sustained voltage, or this is known as Barkhausen criteria for the oscillation. Barkhausen criteria for the oscillation. This important case 3 is very important, that give the sustained oscillation, that is amplitude remains constant with respect to time. And what we want to have a circuit in which this kind of oscillation is there. The one very important thing is, whenever we are talking about this one is AF is equal to infinity. So, this V0 dash upon VI, V0 dash upon VI. So, what this is? VI dash is equal to V0 upon infinity. So, this is 0. VI dash is equal to 0. VI dash is 0 means no input. No input is there. No input is there. Or we can say output signal is there without input signal. Or no AC input power, no AC input power. And this is basically oscillator, because there is output. But the circuit designs in such a way that we will get output signal without input signal. So, input signal is 0. And this is the difference between amplifier and oscillator. In amplifier, we have input voltage and then output amplified voltage. In case of oscillator, there is no input signal, but we have output signal. So, this is today's lecture, that is how the Barkhausen criteria gives the concept of the oscillator, that is without input signal, there is an output signal. And in the next video, we would like to discuss some important circuits through which we can produce the sustained oscillation using Barkhausen principle. Thank you.